Hello everyone, wish you all a very 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 happy 2021. I know all of us had a lot of hopes and dreams for 2020, but it did not turn out the way we wanted. But nevertheless, and I'm sure all of us learned a lot from 2020. All of us learned to hope, to wait, to enjoy the little things in life, to be grateful for what we had, and so on. So yes, I wish that we all will enter 2021 with the same positive attitude, with gratitude, and make the most out of this year. So without any further delay, so let's just get on to the tutorial. So I am Savitri from All Things Beautiful, and I'm here with a wonderful tutorial for craft angles for this month's challenge. And this month's challenge is something which is very close to my heart, which is recycle, upcycle. Yeah, I love to recycle and upcycle stuff around the house, and that is one of my passions, the DIY passions. And I was very happy that this is the theme for craft angles this month. So what I'm going to be doing is, see, I have all these stuff. I have been collecting this for years now. This is a alcohol packing case. The bottle comes in this case. It's a nice sturdy material. So I have this, and I have some old trays with me. This is a plant tray, and I have this very old rusted tray with me. So yeah, I'm going to be trying to make something out of this. So I'm not going to reveal what I'm making. You will see as you follow the video. So let's just get started. I had already used this tray earlier to make some Christmas stuff. So I had painted it in red and gold. So I will try and remove this a little bit at least before we kind of start work on this. So I sanded the tray. I could do only this much. As much as I can, I have done it. And this is the tray. Now I will prime this tray with gesso completely. I will also prime this plant plate with gesso. So my one coat of gesso is dry. I'm just going to leave it with one coat because we are going to be doing a decoupage on this. For that, I am taking this beautiful vintage journals one from Craft Angles. This decoupage paper is absolutely a pretty vintage design with a lot of newsprint, script, stamp kind of a picture. It's really, really, really gorgeous for all your vintage antique kind of projects. And I am going to use this for the tray here. These decoupage papers are comes in A4 size. There are 4 sheets in each packet, and this is very, very economical. It's called the vintage journal one. It's absolutely pretty. So please do check on their site for all these vintage designs. They are just gorgeous. So what I'll be doing here is, I think I will use this. I'm just going to see what fits. I have to use 2 papers, so. Now, before we move on to pasting these on the tray, I want to paint the sides. So I will choose some color that will match with this, so it will blend well. So the plate is completely dry now. You'll see that I have mixed few colors here just to match the decoupage paper. So we had already cut this in cap. So this is how I am going to place it. So the plate is ready. I just gave like one coat of varnish here, and this bottle case that I had showed earlier, that also I painted in the same color as the border of the plate. And I have also painted the plant plate with the same thing. So all these are drying. I just gave like a one thin coat of varnish. So now is the main feature product. Till now it was just a simple decoupage on a plate, but now I'm going to show you a wonderful product. It's a new release from Craft Angles. It is the Foil Magic glue. It's like a gilding glue, and today I'm going to be using this reactive foil. It's rose gold. Believe me guys, I have already used these in a couple of projects before I did this project for you all, and it's just awesome. There are umpteen number of ways you can use these foils, and they are so versatile. And the thing is, the best thing is that you don't need a laminator for this. It's like a heating tool, which I came to know only when I came to know about the reactive foils, only when I opened my DT kit and I learned about these reactive foils. So I don't have a laminator, so I was wondering how to use these foils, and that is when Craft Angles has released this, launched this wonderful multi-purpose foil magic glue, which can be used with the reactive foils and also with gilding flakes. So yes, you will be seeing a lot of projects from all the DTs showing you how to use these reactive foils and the flakes in different ways. And guys, these foils take your project to the next level. They just add that beauty to your work. So do check out the website and buy some colors for yourself. They come in various colors. So today I will not be, for this particular project, I am not going to be using this foil magic. The reactive foils can be used in many different ways. They can be used with the foil magic glue, they can be used with normal glue, they can be used with such double tapes. They can be used with these double tapes also. If you remember, I had actually added another piece here to complete the plate. If you actually see, there is since it's a print kind of a paper, you can't really make out, but there is a kind of a demarcation there. So what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to put this tape on that area. Just to give the shape of the plate. I want this to be like a shabby chic plus vintage kind of a look. So I'm just making sure it's kind of straight. I guess it's fine. So I have put this now and I will remove the top layer. So the top layer comes off. And you're left with. So what I'm doing is I'm going to take a thin strip from my reactive foil. The best part about these reactive foils is nothing goes waste. Every corner, every bit can be used well. Okay, so what you do is keep the color side up and press it down onto the tape nice and firm. You need to give pressure, and that is when your foil is going to get stuck to the sticky tape. Pressure is very important. If you want, you can use a card or anything to give that pressure and press it down. So yeah, I am just using my finger. So let's see how that comes out. This tape is quite sticky, so I guess it should come out well. And if you pull it out, can you see that? Isn't that gorgeous? No. So there are like tiny places where it's not there. So nothing to worry. All you have to do is you can just go over those areas and you know, press and pick it up. It's like waxing, guys. It is so satisfying. Believe me, you have to try this. It's so satisfying to do this job. I just love it. So similarly, I am going to do this other end. Like I said, see, nothing goes waste. The foil has come out so nicely, clearly. So I will put the next part here and press it down. Pull it up. Beautiful. It's just gorgeous, and I love the way it accents the plate. It's this, the color really matches well. So what I am going to do is I will just add one on this side as well, maybe like this. Yes, so I just love this tape method also. It's so easy, no drying time, nothing. But yeah, depending on your project, you can use either tape or foil magic or anything. See guys, we have used every bit. So even if you use after you cut a piece, even if you use only little bit for one project, do not throw away the foil. Keep it in your stash. You can use it for other projects. Isn't that great? I just love it. It just gives a nice look to the plate. Okay, so for this, I'm just going to do like a band around. Okay, so I have my plate ready here. I also have this base that I did ready. What I have done is I have filled this base with some stones. Okay, I don't know if you can see it. So I have just filled this bottle case, this tin, with some pebbles here just to give it some weight and firmness. And my base is also ready. So what I'm going to be doing is, I'm sure by now you all would have guessed what I'm planning to do. So I am going to be making this into a tall tray table, or a side table you can call it, with a tray. So this is my base, and I'm going to put this on this base and the plate on it. And for that, I'm going to be using this E6000, which is an industrial standard glue. I will glue it and then show you. Yeah, I'll just show you guys from a different angle so you understand. I have this base. It was a plant pot plate. So I have the base here. Then I have this, I have filled it up with stones for the weight. I'm going to place it like this, and then my beautiful tray, and I'm going to place this on top. And this is how my tall tray table is going to look. So I am going to use this glue and fix all of them together. So here's our beautiful tall tray table. Tallware is basically a painted metal sheet, decorative trays. And I had one which is very old metal tray, and I have upcycled that into a beautiful, beautiful vintage shabby chic tall tray side table. And it looks absolutely gorgeous. I just love the way it has turned out. And the accent product here being the foil, reactive foils, and the foil magic glue from Craft Angles. The tray table really looks chic and shabby and vintage and also antique. I can pretty much use it around the house in different ways. I'm very, very happy with the outcome. It looks so beautiful. Do try it out, guys. And we have upcycled trash items like old pot tray, a bottle case, and a tray, metal tray. You can also use like big, huge thali plates if you have. And look at the outcome. It's absolutely, absolutely gorgeous. And it definitely is a trash to treasure project. And it, the outcome is a piece of art. I'm loving it. Hope you guys loved it too. Please do hop onto my channel, All Things Beautiful, for more such interesting videos. And do check out the HNDMD blog for posts from the other design team members for loads and loads of creative crafts. Happy crafting, and have a wonderful, wonderful year. Thank you so much. Bye bye.